Masenata Wea County ya Kisi Moske Richard Mumoima Onyonka asema mbiye litukulia lero asege ikarokia ba Senata ya se County ya Nairobi nigagania kumanya igoro ya mabaga yemeremo asichinse chaisiko na ale ngago cha saba saibense ya Kenya anene liboli elio amuboli ya umo Prime Cabinet Secretary Musalia Mudavadi amono mwaziri wa manganawe chinse chaisiko asate vile serikali ya arole kanile kobeka chisa icho kwa iwana igoro ya korosibu wa mate obu ya gati ya Kenya ne chinse chaisiko unenjeremo yugo chago konya basaigo kori meremo asichinse chiri ya boigo na ataka kumanyanga ninki ya Kenya bange wako nyolere mechande kerobara asichinse chaisiko okora meremo ya boti kango totegerene na kuhuligere lia haroboti usenkuwa na yaye omo Senator Richard Mumaima Onyonka.
First of all, I would like to say that I'm happy that you're dealing with this issue. I have previously, as you are aware, worked in the same position you are working now. And one thing that has shocked me, Madam Speaker, is that the things that we were talking 10 years ago, it looks like nothing actually did happen. So I would like to ask the Minister to tell me that out of all the bilateral labor agreements that you've signed with the countries that you've signed, the question I wanted to ask you is whether you are proactively, and if indeed, as you say, that these agreements are going to deliver some fruits, whether you are proactively engaging yourself in preparation to make it possible that when these people are able, our people are able to go and get these jobs, they could be handled and managed in settling in and what needs to be done, and whether the minister is aware that the reason why the labor contracting agreements in our country and the reason why our people keep suffering out there once they go to those countries to work is because most of those agreements are actually hidden. Nobody knows what actually is written in there. Nobody understands what the terms and conditions are. So I'm hoping that when the minister has signed those agreements, he will enable the Labour Committee of the Senate to interrogate that agreement and make sure that we are able to understand what is in it and what we have gained, and if any, what the terms and conditions are. Madam Speaker, the last issue, which is a continuum of the same question I'm asking, is that I don't know whether the CS is aware that if you look at social media, somebody came and posted where they say that they are currently in the US, in Iowa, and out of the 400 people who are now Kenyans who are working in Iowa, this gentleman realized that all the 400 come from one given Kenyan community. The question I wanted to ask the minister is whether he's aware that his government is recruiting individuals according to their tribes and shipping them over to whichever country they are going to work, and whether he is trying to solve that problem given the fact that Kenyans are expecting equity and fairness when these opportunities come, particularly given that many of us in the Senate represent the county governments. Can the minister promise this House that when those positions come out and they're going to be distributed to Kenyans, particularly those ones that are targeting certain areas, that all our 47 counties are going to be included, and they will also get the small cake of whatever that the government is trying to bake? Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Prime Cabinet Secretary.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. First of all, I want to state that one of the things we want to pursue in government and even in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs is an open government policy. By open government policy means that we do not intend to hide any information. We want to share information with Kenyans. They're entitled to it. And therefore, when we conclude any MOUs, they shall not be hidden. They shall be made available to the relevant committees of Parliament. And as I said, Madam Speaker, is that one of the things we are also planning to do, to bring before Parliament, is a sessional paper to have our members deliberate and guide appropriately on Kenya's foreign policy, foreign and diaspora policy. Because all along, this has been confined to the executive, documents are confined to the executive. We want, for the first time, a comprehensive discussion on Kenya's foreign policy and some of these issues, I'm sure, we will benefit